Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting and today I'm coming to share with you ID cards. I love to add to ID cards to my journals and to my creations, but sometimes I'm having problem to find them, so I'm gonna create them myself. I made a collection of different ID cards and passports and papers, pages inside. It will be on my Etsy. Down below will be link if you are interested to have a look. There are passport covers. This is Russian, Germany, Hungarian, and of course Czech. There is one British passport, and that I will show you today, and also hopefully a few others. There are some passport pages. They are in two different sizes, but you can mix and match them together. And those passport covers, they are in bigger size, so if you will use the smaller size of pages, you will just need to wrap the paper around the chipboard or card you're gonna use for cover, and these should be exactly same like it's the cover, the picture of the cover. So just distress those edges because it will be in vintage style. So there are those covers. There are also pages, the bigger ones, and some of them are already filled with photographies and with all that writing, but some of them, they do have maybe just writing and it's missing photography. Here is fully loaded. There are also totally blank pages for stamps. And there are pages like this and like this in those smaller. There are pages also with photographies or without photography, but with writing, or also without anything at all. And you, it will be up to you to create, to put their photography, because this collection has 36 of larger photographies, and then I think 9 small photographies. Those small photographies will be for those cards. There are French identification cards. There are also press cards. And this, it's empty. This card is empty. I hope I've got it somewhere. I'll show you what I did already, fussy cut out. Hopefully we will have it there. And if not, I'm gonna print it again. So in this collection are also photographies you can add there. And that writing, it's up to you. You will fill all those forms, the name, the address, date of birth, these small pages. Here also blank, so name, date of birth, photography here. And because some of these passports have sometimes stamps, there is also a few stamps in this collection. Here I already used some stamps here and here. But you will have their stamps, I will show you later. So this I could for those small cards from just some, not cereali box, but you know, from box, like home find box. And these are already what I have created. So on those sheets, you will find also this British passport. This is on one sheet, this is back side, and this is on another sheet, this is front side of the British passport. And I'm gonna start with this. It should be put together this way. These pages are folded inside, and we will create beautiful, beautiful passport. Here are some stamps, small ephemera, another identification cards, and another stuff in this collection. At this check, banknote, these cards in few different colors, press card. So you can see here, you should put the picture and fill the name. So any name you like, you will create your unique ID cards. There are also ephemeras, small tickets and small postmarks. So you can add it to your creations, and few words. You will find there words like this. So I'm gonna show you what I have already made. Are these small identification cards, this press card. These are press cards and I really love them. They are small and they can be at, you know, to any kind of journals. So this is that British passport. And here I just played with French identification card, so you can add there really so many things. Here I add that small ephemera. So we will start with that British passport. I already pre-cut that back cover. I'm gonna cut out also this front cover. Fussy cut out. I think I can do this because it's just straight line. So hopefully I can do that. The back cover I cut exactly on the edges, this front cover. I'm gonna leave here that white frame, which my printer, it's always printing with all my images. I'm gonna leave it there because I'm gonna use it like gluing point. So I'm gonna cut it just this way. And you can also distress all these edges with distress ink of your choice. So I'm gonna fold all these pieces. Here I'm gonna fold it this way to the edge. Like this. And here I'm gonna do same. Fold it here. And this fold to the edge. Like this. And then what you can do, so this will be front cover of our passport and this will be back cover of our passport. I'm gonna distress all these edges. So I have distressed both sides, these parts I have distressed a little bit more because I'm not sure if I will just glue it together or maybe I will add there some page. So you can just flip it over and glue it together, or to make it exactly precise, put the front cover folded to folded back cover. Here are openings. So here is back cover and here is front cover. So put them together and match these edges like this. Lay it on your table. Open that back cover because that front cover, it's a little bit longer, and fold that front cover around the edge. Take your glue and put the glue here on this page, on that edge of that page, and fold it back. Like this. And now we can fully glue that back cover to this page, or you can make a pocket. So I decided to make a pocket. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna add here glue and on the bottom and just place it here. Like this. So when you open it, you've got pocket from here in that back cover. So we can add there later some tags. Then flip this. And here you can decide if you will glue these two pages together. I will place it. Put glue here, here and here and just flip it over and press it together. Or you can add there some extra pages. You could hear this one. This is French. That passport is Russian, but I'm not making, what is it, falsificate? I'm making art. So I think I'm gonna use it because I like it. So what I'm gonna do, here can be at photography, here can be at some name and, you know, signature, something like that. So I'm gonna put glue. Don't look on that background that I messed up with another printing. So I had to print out on different papers. And I'm using this one. So I'm putting glue on the fold and on the top side and bottom side. And I'm gonna match this fold of my insert to this fold here. I'm gonna place in it kinda in the middle like this, and as you can see, here is the spine. If you noticed, sometimes the passports are not opening exactly, they have that fold. So what I'm gonna do, first we need to do something with that, you know, this is that unfolding from that front cover. So first we need to glue this page to that front cover. And I think I'm gonna do another pocket. So I'm gonna add, here we've got that front page, front cover. So on this second page, I'm gonna add glue here on the bottom. And here on this side. And fold it down like this. And now that rest, here, what kind of pocket? Down there. So here I would like to have pocket from the from the top, like that side pocket. So I'm gonna add glue here and here. Here and on the bottom. And I'm gonna fold this top. Like this. And here I've got a small piece which I need to put off. It's not properly dry yet, so if I will unfold it right now, it will mess up probably all my book. I will try. So then we are opening like this. And we have many pockets in there. We've got pocket here, and pocket here, and pocket here. So this is one type of passport. Once it will be totally dry, I'm gonna add there some tags and stuff like that. Then I've got here those covers. So I'm gonna take some of these pages and where is my cardstock? I think I lost my cardstock somewhere. Where is it? I've got my book pages, passport pages, but I don't have that proper cardstock I need. Here is covers. Yeah, I lost it. There you are. Okay. And I'm gonna use some of these smaller ones. So this is that smaller cutted piece from, yeah, those are these breaded cheese. They are amazing. So here we've got French, Czech, Czech, French, and this is Old Germany, both of them. So I think here is no picture. Here is picture. I'm gonna mix them. I'm gonna mix those two or three. And I'm gonna choose this black one. Okay, so what I'm gonna do, I've got straight corners, and I will put corners once it will be glued together. So I'm gonna put glue on all my cardstock, this piece of box. And I'm gonna place it on my paper, and here I need to use, you know, the light to see where I am with my cardstock, to place it kind of in the middle of everything. Yes, like this, so I can see through where is that print. Gonna press it properly with this cloth. Aha. Give me my paper. I think there was some glue on my table. Now I'm gonna cut these corners, and because then I will cut the corners, make them less sharp. I don't like these straight corners. So I don't mind about some measurement around the corners, because I will put them anyway. Like this. And I'm gonna glue it to my chipboard. Fold it over and press it properly. Same on this other side. Fold it over. And same these long pieces. Fold it. And last one. And fold it. Make it look more vintage. I'm gonna cut these straight corners because I just don't like it. They are too straight, so I'm gonna use my scissors and cut just small top of that corner. Really teeny meeny small top of these corners. Like this. I'm gonna use distress ink and distress all edges. I would like to fold it, but I'm not sure if it's too dry already. I'm gonna fold it half. Where is my bone folder? Ah, there you are. Burnish, open it. And I'm gonna distress all these edges, outside and inside as well. So I do have distress all edges, outside and inside as well. I also distress the edges of these three pages. And I'm gonna start to glue them somehow together. What I have noticed in old passports, it was in Czech passports, I'm not sure if it was everywhere. There was a string through to that passport, so I'm gonna create that. I'm gonna put the string through to those pages. And what I have decided, that French one will be here, right on the top. from the start, so I'm gonna glue it straight away. I think I'm gonna put the glue here, and this is another my bad printing. I just choose wrong side of papers for that printing, so I had to choose another one. But you know, for projects like this, that old print can be hidden inside, so I don't mind. So this is my front, and this will be right here. I need to fold this to make sure there is a space, and glue it down like this. This one, it's for Visa stamps, so that will be on the end. So I'm gonna put glue here. But before I will put there glue, I need to put there that string. I've got prepared here my needle. Kind of similar string, if you will notice that string, it's red and white. So I'm gonna make two dots kind of in the middle here. Yes. And I'm gonna go which way? I'm gonna go. Oh, I need to make one here. So it will go this way. From here. Oh, the other side. And this way. Yeah, come on. And back like this. And back to that one hole. And this is too long. Okay. I need to pull this a little bit. Otherwise it will be really too long. I think it was in those old passports somehow like this ish. And I think now I made mistake. I should first glue this on that page. Yeah, I should first glue that on that page. See? Okay. I'm gonna pull it out. And first I will glue my another page, which will continue. Okay, this page will be here. And maybe I can do small pocket. I'm gonna put glue here, like nice big space, especially around the hole, to make sure it will everything hold here on the top and here on the bottom, and make sure that it will be right way. Yes. And here, I'm gonna match these edges. Like this. So once it will be dry, I will have pocket here for something. And I'm gonna glue it straight away in this on this page as well, and then I will go with the thread. Yes, that way will be best. but here I'm not sure which way, which side. It's a little bit bigger. I'm gonna distress this, these edges as well. I forgot. So I just made distressing. And I'm gonna glue it together. Yeah, this way I'm gonna glue it together. So I'm gonna put glue here. And here I'm not gonna do any pocket. There will be just one pocket in this passport, and I think it will be okay. Because I can add there things, you know, with staples. This way. Okay. Match it here on the bottom and make sure there is space here. Like this. Okay, so now I'm gonna go back with my needle and thread. I'm gonna make a hole through. Yep, and I go with the thread this way. I'm gonna leave a small piece here on the end. I'm gonna go here around there and there, and I will go back with that thread to that start, and then I will use that sealing wax to create some kind of vintage look, some document look. So here. And in that hole, I'm gonna go back. Yes, just here. Yep. This way. This way. Yes. So before I will use that sealing wax, I'm gonna glue to the last page. So I'm gonna add quite a lot of glue here, where is the thread or that string in the back side or back page, last page. I'm gonna glue it all over as well to make it strong enough to hold. Like this. Fold everything on the right position, press it inside. Yes, yes, and here I'm gonna use the sealing wax. Oh, yeah, I hope I'm not gonna drop it. It should be. Melted. Needle. And I'm gonna press this one. And press it down. Yeah, there is something. I've got there, I think, the moon. I hope you can see that. I've got there moon and hand. So I'm gonna cut these strings a little bit. Wonderful. And here is space for some photography, so I should use some photography. And this is with the name and with the signatures. So which which picture I'm gonna use. Bueno, him or not him. It's Louis. Okay. Oh, it can be probably woman as well. Why not? I think. Who's gonna be my Louis? Oh, I got him. This guy gonna be my Louis. Okay. I'm gonna distress a little bit those edges. And I'm gonna add that glue. Oh. And place his picture here. Like this. So I've got another passport. Now just need to sit down and dry everything. And I've got French, Czech. Yeah, French check passport. There is so many more. So if you are interested to create your own passport for your journals, go to have a look. Link will be down below. I'm gonna start to put some photographies here. I think I'm gonna use some lady, and try to make some interesting. Maybe hair. Yeah, maybe hair. So I'm gonna create something with this and continue with all those other stuff to prepare some of these ID cards and passports for my journals. I hope you did enjoy it. Even my mistake. Have a wonderful day. Thank you so much for visiting me today. Take care about yourself and see you next time. Bye.